The Bell XP-59A Airacomet is America's first jet-powered aircraft. The Airacomet was intended to be a jet fighter, but during tests they realized that while it was fast, its top speed was about 400 miles an hour, it was still significantly slower than the best conventional airplanes at the time. It was not enough to make it a viable military fighter. And they built a total of 75 as advanced trainers to teach a whole new generation of fighter pilots how to fly a jet. The primary challenge was to learn the new technology of jet propulsion. Jet engines were new, and they needed to teach a whole corps of pilots the special characteristics of a jet. There's a pretty long learning curve. During some tests of the aircraft, they actually removed the guns from the nose and put in a position for an observer to gather data on the flight of the aircraft and the engine. During these tests, the observer sat in the front in the open. Jet engine gets all of its power from the thrust from its exhaust. The exhaust out of a jet is extraordinarily hot. Because of that, two Whittle engines are mounted underneath the aircraft, and the tail is out of the way of the exhaust because you don't want parts of the aircraft melted away. The Airacomet project was a closely guarded secret in 1942. We didn't want Germany or Japan to know that we were working on a jet. As America's first jet, it is America's first step into the jet age.